Well, today we have 186 new cases. Now, this is the largest that Queensland has had during the entire pandemic. We have none who are in hospital wards requiring COVID care, which is fantastic news. And Dr. Gerard will give us some more information. So what we are seeing, some preliminary advice is that the vaccines appear to be working and they are protecting Queenslanders from getting seriously sick. But also too, a big reminder to those Queenslanders that are not vaccinated, now is the time to go and get vaccinated. For those Queenslanders who haven't had their booster shot, please go and get their booster shot when the time arrives, because we know the booster is an added layer of protection. So of course we've had 15,698 vaccines administered by Queensland Health, and 34,518 tests have been administered. So now 89.94% of Queenslanders have had one dose. So I'm pretty sure Queensland we're going to hit that 90% mark today. So well done, congratulations. And of course we're 83.55% have had two. Now, in terms of people coming into Queensland, we've had 257,000 people have crossed the border from Victoria, ACT and New South Wales since Monday. Obviously, everyone wants to come to Queensland, but we want to make sure that it is safe. So if you think about it, it's more than the population of Townsville has come into Queensland. We are a tourist destination. Now, because this variant, the Omicron, is highly contagious, we want to ensure that Queenslanders and people coming to Queensland have a safe Christmas and a safe New Year. And that means we need to do as much protection as we possibly can. If you get this COVID, you'll be off work from anything from 7 to 10 days. And if you're a close contact, you'll be off work for 7 days. So what we know is we want to keep our restaurants and our cafes and everything operating over Christmas and New Year. This is really important, as well as our critical industries across Queensland as well. So we're doing a lot of planning, and I want to reassure Queenslanders that all of that work is happening. So we're going to add some extra measures to continue to keep Queensland safe. And these are not onerous measures, but they're measures that Queenslanders have taken before. So in Queensland, we already have masks that are mandatory in supermarkets and shops, on public transport and in ride shares. So starting from 5 a.m. tomorrow, masks will be mandatory in cinemas and theatres. So this is for patrons and for people who work in cinemas and theatres, and also for hospitality staff. Now, we know in hospitality staff, people go around from table to table. We all don't have that full protection yet because we don't have the boosters. This is not very onerous. We have spoken to the industry and to the unions. They understand why this is necessary. Essentially, we don't want to have all of our cafes and restaurants going down because of the Omicron variant. So I think it's very practical. It's very sensible. And I'm quite sure that Queenslanders will respond positively to this move as we head into Christmas and New Year. It's only a few days out from Christmas and a few days out from New Year, and I want to ensure that Queenslanders have a very good Christmas. So I might just hand over to Dr. Gerard, and then I'm happy to take a few quick questions because we have National Cabinet. Look, I might just address the issue of PCR tests if I can. I know that's been coming up a lot. Look, I spoke to the New South Wales Premier. We had a really good conversation. Our information is about 10% of their tests are for people wanting to come into Queensland, so not 80% or 90%, 10%. We are happy to get some further advice from AHPPC about rapid antigen tests. We will look at, if this is approved, that we may be able to utilise them in the new year from the 1st of January. But between now and the new year, we will require those PCR tests for people coming into our state. It was part of our plan, and we want to keep the virus out as much as we possibly can over the Christmas and New Year stages. And the final thing is just in relation to our vaccination hubs. There's been some reporting in the media. I just want to reaffirm that Queensland has 23 vaccination locations operating over the Christmas break. Of course, there's GPs and pharmacies. And we will have the same number of hubs that have been operating during this pandemic. So there may be some reports in other states of vaccination hubs closing, but if we do have some that are scaled down, we'll be putting extra ones out in different areas. But we'll still have essentially the same number, which is around 23.